I've said it before and I'll say it again. Please don't use Trello as a CRM without Crmble installed. At first glance, you may think that this Trello board looks pretty typical, but if we take a bit of a closer look, you can see that there's some very important differences. Number one, we have the deal value listed here on the front of many of our cards, so we can see at a glance the value of these clients. And second of all, and perhaps even more apparent, we have won and lost data visible on the front of the card. So we can see which deals we have won, and we can also keep track of the deals and why we lost those particular deals. But let's go one step further and open up one of our cards, because maybe the biggest difference with using Crmble with Trello is that we have access to contact information right here from within the card. No longer do you need to copy and paste things here in the description field or try to create a large number of custom fields, which you can't report on. You can't really do anything with custom fields that you create here within Trello. Rather, we have that contact information at our fingertips. We can create new contacts directly from each Trello card, and then we can repurpose them as these customers perhaps come back to us for future sales. Best of all, we can keep track of that won and lost information. And you know what? I just won this deal, so let me select that button so we can keep track of that, and more importantly, report on that information at a later time. Now, these features alone make Crmble essential for using Trello as a CRM, but it gets even better. If I come up to the top of my board and select the Crmble button, I have access to the all new dashboard. Now I can take all of that information, all of the contact information, all the deals that I've won or lost, and view it here in something that is so much more meaningful. Within the Crmble dashboard, I have a win summary in the top left-hand corner. So I can see that we've won 8 deals, which is better than the 5 that we won last month, and that we've just surpassed our goal of $20,000. And even that is a little better than what we did last month at 20.5. On the right-hand side, I can see exactly who those 8 leads are. If I click on any of these, they will take me directly back to my Trello card. But here within the dashboard, I can see which members of my team have been assigned, when that particular deal was won, and the value of the deal. At the bottom of this screen, I can also see a timeline view as to when those deals were won, seeing that certain days and certain weeks in particular have been better for us. But keep in mind, when it comes to reporting your Trello information, this is just the tip of the iceberg. Here within the reports menu, we have even more data to look at, including our complete sales funnel here on the left-hand side. So at a glance, I can see that we have 28 new leads, 24 in proposal review, and 18 as a part of a discovery call. On the top right hand of the screen, I can highlight and make sticky some of the most important numbers to me. So for example, maybe I want to make sure that we have at least 20% of our leads in proposal review. I can keep this number visible to me at all times. And if I want to change that to something else, I can maybe change this to a discovery call, for example. That's only at 11%, and I can save this view if I want to. We can also filter by that won and lost information. So if I want to dive down a little bit deeper just into the deals in which we have won, I can use this filter as well. But speaking of filters, that's the real power of Crmble. Here in the top right-hand corner, I can dive deeper even further. I can specify the time range. I can specify a member of my team. I'm just going to click on Alberto here so I can see what he's been doing recently. And I can filter by label. And the great thing here is that you don't have to manage two different systems. When I select labels, these are the labels which I've created within Trello. These aren't specific to Crmble. No matter how many labels I create within Trello, I will have access to them here within the Crmble dashboard and reporting features, so I can make use of them. But the last checkbox here may be the most powerful and something that we don't want to ignore. As a Trello user, you will know that you will need to archive certain cards after a certain period of time. For example, after you have won X number of clients, you don't want to necessarily keep them here within the finalized list. Or maybe the same could be said for your future call list. Eventually, you'll want to archive and remove them from the visibility of this board. But you certainly don't want to remove them from its reporting capabilities. So if we go back to the Crmble interface and select filters, you can see that I can choose to include the archived information or exclude it. In default mode, you can see that this has been excluded. We have 28 leads, but if I check this box, it's now going to refresh that data. I now have 40 leads in total, and all of my other information has been updated as well. With this simple checkbox, you can keep your Trello boards uncluttered, but still always have access to that information right here from within Crmble. Continuing on the left-hand side of the screen, we have our complete contacts list. So all of those contacts which you or members of your team have added within those Trello cards will remain here, so you can quickly and easily find them and dive in a little bit deeper. In this example here, I can see that Ahmed is actually attached to 4 different Trello cards here. So I can quickly see at a glance where they are, the dates related to them, when they were created, and the information related to them as well. And of course, if I click on these cards, they will take me directly back to that Trello card. Here in the top right-hand corner, we can also add new contacts from this screen, but perhaps more importantly, we can import from any other CRM system or maybe some other spreadsheet that you are maintaining. And if you ever need to export your Crmble information, you can do so via CSV or Excel. But if you're still not convinced that Crmble is the best CRM solution for Trello, let me show you a feature which is my personal favorite. Here we are returned to our Trello board, and I'm going to go back and open up this card. Here's this card which we just selected as one a few moments ago. Now, it's great that I have access to their contact information directly here, both their phone number, their work email address, and of course, I can customize as many additional fields here if I like to. Now, I could select this little link here, which would open up my default email client. But why waste my time when I can email them directly from within the card? If I click on this Gmail icon here, you can see that I can write a message directly from within Trello. It'll even give me the option to choose from which email address I would like to send this message if I happen to be managing several. Crmble also allows us to create and store as many different templates as we like. So in this case, I'm going to choose the follow-up template, and automatically that customer information is input directly within this template. Last but not least, down below, the signature at the bottom, that's coming in directly from my Gmail account. I didn't even have to create this within Trello or within Crmble. It is linked directly to my account. Now by hitting send, this email is sent to that particular client. And if I come down to the activity section of my Trello card, I have a preview, a snippet of that precise email. Best of all, if this client decides to reply to my message, their email will appear right here within the activity section as well. I said it earlier, and I'll say it again. Please don't use Trello as a CRM without Crmble. To learn more and to start your 3-week trial, go to crmble.com. And remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.